Hello and welcome to week 23 of RollPlay Solum. My name is JP McDaniel, also known on the show as Zanzel. I'm joined by the rest of the cast, Tariq, Victorian Black. Did we decide? Is it Leah? Is it Leia? What are we going with?
Leah.
God damn it, I can't say that!
Your accent Leia. Doesn't... It's Leia. Like, you say something in the middle, it's like, is it Leah or Leia? Yeah. And you're like, Leah! It's like, oh. That was both, I think.
We're joined by Jin. There we go. And of course, our Dungeon Master, Koibu. I can't say that Ryan? Name.
What about Ryan? Doesn't he count?
I said Tariq.
Tariq.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
I was going. That's why. God, Neil, stick to the script. Ryan was late writing the script, and he didn't even read it.
Well, 500.
Oh, you all were late. I've been here waiting. I've been listening to the drops.
All right. Let's find out what everyone's been up to. Neil, you said you were going to save your shout outs for tonight. Is that at the end of the show? Should we just skip you and Ryan?
Ryan, you go first.
I'll go first. Perfect. So in the break between, what was it, Roleplay Vigil and now,
yeah.
I got some dinner, hashtag Chipotle.
No. Nice. I got Chipotle too. What'd you get?
Delicious. My PC is in the shop. Going to be able to pick it up tomorrow. Hashtag Friday. Hashtag good day. hashtag streaming.
I feel Can't like I missed for that. I think I missed a hashtag joke.
It's just
here.
How I do my shout outs now. So okay.
I talked about how I hate fucking hashtags, and we were laughing at Tumba, who just did the stupidest exchange with his wife on Twitter, and now Ryan's trolling.
Ah, okay. Gotcha. I'm into it. Let's keep the trolling going, Ryan.
Yeah. So that's pretty much all I've been doing on the break, but like, you know.
Hashtag Chipotle, man. I'm into
What's
that.
Up? I'm happy to be here.
What'd you get from Chipotle? That's how the white folks say it down here in Texas.
Hashtag
they don't actually
chicken,
say Chipotle,
chicken
do they?
Burrito? No. It's called Chipotle here in Texas.
No fucking.
I'm dead serious.
Of our hostesses?
Yeah.
My God.
I'm totally serious. What'd you get, Ryan, at Chipotle?
Chicken burrito, man.
Just, man. I get that.
What do you get at Chipotle? There's only one thing to get. It's a different kind. It's either steak, chicken, or beef burrito.
I level the game up. I get a bowl with no rice, double black beans, grilled veggies, double chicken, and cheese.
You let me see that post on Imgur about how to get the most out of your double orders of chicken and beans.
Yes, you don't say double before, and then after they put one scoop, you say, I'd like double, please, because then they have to add a second scoop.
I just
want to
make sure that you're on top of your shit.
No, I knew that before that post. Neil, I'm a big guy, all right? I've been doing this for years. Get on the level.
Good. You guys know that. And also at Pan Express, you ask to go because it's a bigger plate they'll give you.
Yeah. Boom. There you go.
You can also just, at Chipotle, you can just be like, can you just put a little bit more meat
on
it? And
they'll
do it.
That's weird. Everyone around is like, oh my God.
If you're going to scam the system, look, if you're going to scam the system, then fucking scam the system. Like, just do it, man. Like, don't have any hangups. Just, like, fucking do it.
Look, I don't want to have any lasting.
Like, bro, that meat is looking a little light. Just, like, top it off a little bit, bro.
Ryan, I go there every day. I'm at Chipotle every day, all right? I can't be pissing off the employees.
And if you try that double scoop method continuously, they're like, dude, I fucking know you're going to ask for another scoop. Like,
it hasn't happened yet. It hasn't happened
yet. You have to, like, if you're going to do it on a constant basis, you got to switch up the game.
Maybe so.
Hashtag America.
Hashtag America right
Hashtag
there.
Hashtag America, yeah.
America. Yeah, not America. It's just America.
No.
All right. Ryan, so you're going to be streaming tomorrow? Are you going to be fixing your BIOS?
Tomorrow, we're going to be downloading BIOS, downloading enough RAM so I can run everything, and then, we're going to stream after that.
Okay, maybe we'll stream some Saturday, and I'll teach you the ropes and and some Battle Royale and just kill you.
I'm going to download some headshots.
Yeah, okay.
For sure. That.
Neil, anything happened in the past hour and a half?
I got some soup and some orange juice, made plans for the engagement party we're throwing this Saturday.
Nice.
Just fun stuff. That was the extent of the hour and a half in between here and now.
All right, good.
And
we'll check
I am,
up.
Sorry, a couple. I can't remember what role. I think
oh, that's right. We were going to have this confrontation. Now, Neil was real pissed earlier on Vigil. He was pretty upset, Jeff.
He can be as pissed as he wants. Nobody told me about it, and I'm excited for him, so I fucking talked about it. Like, hey, how'd you not read my mind that was an ultra secret thing? It's like, well,
I just figured Anna had spoken to you already. That's all.
That was your mistake is that Ann and I know everything about each other. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. I'm not used to having to keep things secret, so I never crossed my mind that it would get out via Facebook.
People to know, and this is my defense. If we were in court, this is what I would present as my evidence. All right,
what's the evidence?
His Facebook has not like a. It's not like Neil's.
See, now I did see this, and that's why I didn't stop you. This is why I didn't stop you.
It's just his Facebook, but it turns out that Neil is such a an evil genius, you know, like sinister puppet master man. His Facebook is ultra secretive publicly. Anyone that sees his Facebook is within his inner circle of trustees, and I didn't know that, so I was like, oh, wow, he announced a...
Wait, so you don't keep your now fiancé in your inner circle of trust? Did you invite her afterwards? Is that how you did, like, hold on, let me add you on Facebook, and we'll make this official. Neil, what's going on here?
Well, on top of that, the Facebook invite to the party this Saturday, which is where Jeff got his information, is also restricted even further. So it's not even a public announcement on Facebook. It's a public announcement to a small group of friends in the city.
Neil, I'm going to stop you right there. That was your fault for not understanding that Jeff just doesn't understand computers. Like, that's not his fault at all.
I'm one step above your dad and your mom. Like, on Facebook, clearly 500 million people.
You can push the keys fast. That's about it. That's where it stops, man.
Being a guy who just tried to build his own PC, I'm right along there with you, Jeff.
I am sorry, Neil. I apologize to him, too, but I'm sorry it happened. I'm not sorry.
It's fine. I was just going to wait until my marathon stream and announce it then for bigger hype, but it's okay. It's not a big deal.
It's all right. I think the picture, it was good. I was happy.
Yeah, but I was going to try and milk it for everything it was worth later on.
You were going to try and make money off of it? God damn it, Neil.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah.
For $10,000, I'll let you know that I'm getting married.
All right, guys. We hit $20,000. I'm marrying my girlfriend.
Yeah, I'll propose to her right now on stream. Here we go, guys. You're crazy.
Then I can use that proposal on stream, even though it's already confirmed. We're going to make a killing off of this, Jeff.
Oh, she'd do to you if you did propose on stream. She'd probably
punch me in the face and say, what the fuck is wrong with you for doing this?
That's
you're
the
all
thing.
Dressed up at your computer holder. You're like, honey, can you come in here? Guys, 1 minute.
And I've got like my headphones on still.
But if you would stick to Ryan's script, the thing would be is that at $15,000, she knew that she was going to get proposed. And it was actually a troll to just say no to Neil.
Double troll, yeah.
Oh.
See, then that's how you rig the system right there.
Shit.
Damn it. I should have done that.
Should have done
that. Do it again.
And then you get pity donations.
Yep. The only thing that could fix this is Jeff, you owe Neil $20,000. Because now how is he going to make that money?
I'll pay him back in esports dollars. It shouldn't take long.
Exactly. Jeff, we spoke with you last night on Swan Song, but anything changed in the last 24 hours?
Yeah, actually, I went back to Wolfenstein. I was on the big robot before the final boss. Beat that quite easily. I was like, why did I have a tough time with that before?
Yeah.
Then you shoot a few guys. Then you get to the final boss.
Down there with all the fire and stuff. Yeah. I don't want to spoil it too much.
Don't spoil. I've been playing.
Oh, it's Jen. That's like saying don't spoil like Mortal Kombat or something like that. It's like, okay, well.
There's final boss.
Fine. Spoil it.
Well, no, it's funny. I can't spoil it because I beat the first phase, then the second phase is so fucking stupid. And
the same thing happened to me. I was stuck on that for like 30 minutes just getting so pissed off.
And I wasn't having fun. There's just fire everywhere. He's like, I am still mad.
Dude, I was playing on the hardest difficulty too, and that shit, it was annoying as shit. Like, I just got pissed.
You just keep shooting him until he dies, right? There's no secret here that I'm assuming.
Yeah. There's no like sense of him being low HP. You just keep shooting.
I'll eventually get around to beating it, but I'm just not interested. And all the word on the street is the cutscene's pretty shit. Like you don't play it for the ending. So
yeah, you definitely.
That was
don't.
Disheartening. I know it's a nod to the original Wolfenstein final boss, which is Mecha Hitler with twin Gatling guns. So that's what this is supposed to be kind of a nod to. But like, for a game that was so awesome up until this point, this is a little bit of a letdown. It doesn't ruin the experience for me. Like, it's still just a linear FPS. Go play it. It's cheesy. Yep. It's fucking hilarious. There's great guns, so it's fun.
Yep.
Other than that, I did get my model, my Dimacheron, which is, I believe, Greek or Roman for gladiator. It's this big-ass new Tyranid bug. Finally came in the mail. And it's in a million pieces on the desk because it's not assembled, but in a month.
Do you look at that and look at excitement, or do you just look at how I can pay someone to make this for me? I forget if you make your own.
I'm excited every phase.
Okay.
Like, just getting it, I was like, oh, God, look at all these little pieces. Oh, man, it's mine now. I get really excited about it. And then I hand it off, and it takes fucking forever to paint and put together, and then I'm excited that entire month waiting for it.
Now, is it only Warhammer models that you get into, or is it other models?
I'm only into Warhammer 40K. Okay. I'm kind of a... when I like something, I go hard on it, and everything else is spoiled by it. So there's other tabletop games that other people prefer more.
Yeah.
But this is objectively the most successful, it's the best balance of, like, awesome rules, awesome lore, awesome models. So it's the best. So when other people are like, you should check out this other game, Drop Zone Commander or Flames of War, and I'm like, nope, those are expensive, just less good things. So I just don't experience it. I don't enjoy it nearly as much. Other people can do that. They dabble, but, like, it's kind of like RTS for me. Like, StarCraft II is the best. So
sure.
I will play Command & Conquer for a hot minute. I'll check out Warcraft 3, but because they're not as good, the whole time I'm just like, I want to play StarCraft. Okay. So that's what ends up being.
Check that phone out real quick, bro.
I see it. You're a son of a bitch, Brian.
Wait, there's another... You're just full of inside jokes today. Now I got to know.
Well, it's just more of the same.
Oh. Did you just text him hashtags?
No, yes. I tweeted it. It popped up.
Gotta get that. See, now that's a sick ass model.
Yeah. So this model, I don't know if I could show this, but my brother is like a big comic book guy.
Jesus.
And I don't know. You pre-order these like a year before they come out, and then you get them like, I think this one comes out in like May 2015 or something like that. But that thing looks fucking sick, right? Like, I'm totally gonna order this. They have an entire series.
Just a comic book? I don't even recognize those.
No. This is some. It's called Court of the Dead. It's some standalone thing that they do. Fucking the model just looks incredible, though.
It does.
I think I'm gonna order that. They have some other ones too on their website, but that's why wondering if you're into other models and stuff.
I appreciate them for sure. But I like Warhammer so much. You guys can barely see it, and I've shown it on stream before. But I had a Hive Tyrant sculpted that's like this big. By that awesome C-Not Bush guy that you might have seen, who's done some StarCraft and League stuff.
He streams all of it too. You should check that out.
Oh, I follow him. I check it out. But yeah, I really like that stuff. So that's what's new for me now. I had a terrible stream where I lost like 95% of my games and it was just tilting hardcore. But I won the last like three, so I'm not super grumpy pants, which I was worried about because it was like getting close to the show and I'm like, I don't want to be a dick. Come on, win a couple games. So I did.
Cool. Cool. I'm glad you're here on Solum. Jen, you've been traveling all around the U.S. for eSports the past 2 weeks since we last did a show.
Yes.
We didn't do a show last week, right?
Right.
Nope.
Right. Okay. So since we've talked, you've been in Vegas?
Yeah, I've been to Evo, hashtag Evo 2014.
How was that? The official hashtag of Evo 2014?
Yeah. I saw Jeff's wife more than him this month, which is interesting. because I was also at MLG, and then I was at Evo, and then I was at TI4 with her, so apparently that's all I do. Basically, at Evo, it was really nice. I enjoyed the scene. I bought Evo figurines, and I got the two rares in one box, and they're like both worth $150 each.
Did you sell them?
No, I still have them, but I'm considering selling them.
I saw the tweet. You were like, somebody buy these. I saw it, right? Didn't you tweet
that's
that?
That's not how you sell.
Who wants to buy these?
No, because that's part of my second thing. My second story. Because these I haven't sold.
Okay.
Okay.
Let me do the thing in the progression of it. So, Evo, hashtag Evo 2014. Then I did the first ever Rainbow Six Twitch stream when I came back. Hashtag Rainbow Six Live. It was our first live stream. I hosted it. We just uploaded it to our YouTube, actually. It's youtube.com/rainbow6 with the letter.
Hashtag YouTube,
If you guys want to check it out, it's really cool. You get to see live gameplay, non-scripted, which is really nice.
Wait, Ryan didn't write the script?
Huh?
There was no... Ryan didn't write the script for that?
I ghost-writ the script. My name's not on it, but I...
You sold it to Ubisoft?
Yeah.
They gave you some of those French-Canadian... baguettes for money?
French dollars, which I think are the same as esports dollars. I'm not sure.
No. They're just bread. They just hand you baguettes.
Yeah, I got some bread too. It was good.
Nice. Okay. Well done. Please continue, Jen.
And then I went to hashtag TI4 for my first ever TI4 Dota event and first ever Dota 2 interviews. That was cool, except the media coverage aspect of it was really hard. The players were hard to reach. They were like locked away and really far. And
well, they treat them like actually athletes there.
Yeah, which is terrible for media.
Yeah.
So yeah, I did that coverage for Flaming Cow TV. And then that's when the story that Ryan was talking about kicks in. I bought two figurines, one for myself and one for one of my coworkers that loves Dota. And then I opened the one that Dota? I bought for myself. Turns out it's golden.
So what? It's worth, you got a like, golden, golden what?
A golden slark. And then that's like sold for $220 or some shit. And then I'm like, oh no, golden tiny, yeah. And then I'm like, oh, what if the one I bought for my coworkers is also golden? I should at least open it to make sure. And then it's also golden. Holy fucking shit. So I basically sold the gift I bought him.
Did you sell for $220?
I sold it for $120 plus a normal Slark cash. And basically it paid for everything I bought.
Wait, so you sold something that you were going to give to someone as a gift to pay for everything that you bought?
And then I got him another.
Yeah.
Then I gave him
one.
She was like, I'm going to give you a non-golden gift for a regular gift.
Yeah, because I'm...
So she just downgraded his gift.
Yeah, I'm like, I was like $30 generous, not $220 generous.
I thought you were saying that you got...
I would have done the same.
Like, you bought him a gift, and then you sold it for $200, and then he didn't give him anything.
No, I bought him another, but it's cheaper.
I was about to call you out on that shit. That's good.
Now I have the tattoo tights. Yeah.
Nice.
Like everyone else. All the girls bought them, apparently. And yeah, now I still have a golden tiny, and I have no idea what to do. Like, am I selling it in a year because it's going to be worth more? Should I be selling it now? Should I just sell the code of the card or some shit? I have no idea what people are doing and how much it's worth. And apparently, if I open it, I might get like a 1.5K item Doomling thing.
Yeah, if you get a golden Doomling, those sell for like 1500 or 1200 or 1500.
Yeah, so I have no idea what to do. If you guys have ideas...
Jeff, don't try to make any sense of this world. It is the dumbest thing that has ever existed.
I lived through the Tamagotchis and the Beanie Babies and shit. Yeah. Just like random...
It's on that level of stupidity.
You got the Free Code Sloth Tamagotchi. That one's worth $2,000. Like, why?
Yeah.
Princess Di Bear. That one's worth $5,000.
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah, I have no idea why it's worth so much, but I am enjoying the free money, and my luck is insane right now. Like, two rares for the Evo blind box, and then two goldens for the two figurines I freaking bought, which is ridiculous. So right, yeah, Neil, I don't know what to do with it.
What'd you say, Jeff?
I said, Neil, you know what to do now.
Oh, yeah. That's what I thought you said.
Help her along with her luck train today.
Yeah.
Start off, meteorites coming to you guys. What do you do? Oh, then you can't.
You know, it was just a rock, but it was a big enough rock to actually kill someone, and it hit Jin. Believe it or not. It's crazy.
But now we have Jen's new character, Uncle Oris, back from the dead. Here you go, Jen. I'm not going to tell you anything about him or how to play him at all.
Oh, God. Cool.
He has 2 hit points.
By the way, you are of opposite alignments of the party. You roll for initiative.
All the time. Just
all the time. It's like, guys, you might fight now. Can you please
God
just
damn it.
Give me an initiative check? Cool. All right. Well, let's play some role play song. I guess Neil catch us up on what happened last time, and because I don't even remember where we last left off. We killed some trolls in the forest, and I gave an old mother.
The
kid's leg or some shit all like right. that.
So where last we left off, the party had been hanging out in Dalra for a little while, when all of a sudden this new person shows up in town named Leah.
We don't know.
Jen shows up in town. and starts talking to the party, being like, hey, you know what? I think I'm actually going to... I'm sent here to find you and help kill you, but I've opted to instead help you guys because I believe in the cause that you are fighting for. I used to work for the Verossi's forces, and, well, here's how this goes. And then you guys chatted for a little bit. Some people came after you. You guys ambushed them. Well, not ambushed them. You hunted them down and killed them, dragged their bodies off to the side of the road somewhere, burned them. Jen split off and went to Fallon to talk to some people for a while. The rest of the party hung out in Dalra. And then once everyone got back together, you guys were still waiting for the plate mail to show up. And then you guys heard, you know, some woman came into town being like, oh my god, you've killed these bad people, and now you're such powerful warriors, maybe you can find my little son, he ran off into the forest a while ago and I haven't seen him since. And you guys are like, fine, we'll go trek in the goddamn forest. Fine, walk in the forest for a while, eventually come across a couple of trolls, brutally murder them, set them on fire, come back. JP gives the woman who lost her son a tongue lashing. Be like, you can't, you know, send your kids off into the forest and not expect them to die. There's displacer beasts out there. You know, anyone could die out in the forest, even a seasoned fighter, someone who's, you know, magically inclined and the such. And I think that's where we left off.
Okay. So we're in town. We haven't decided what we're doing, or did we leave town?
Waiting on the armor still, I think.
I think we are still waiting on the armor.
Okay. How long do we have to wait? And Leah's not with us, right? She's to the east. Is that right?
No, she came back and helped you guys with that.
I think it just came back at the end, yeah. And we killed the trolls together, yeah.
Yeah, she was there for the troll killing.
Oh, okay, that's right. Sorry, I was telling Ryan that he should host my channel and give me all his money. Anyways. All right, so we're all in an inn, something like that? Just chilling?
Yeah, waiting on Ron.
I just want to wait. There's nothing I need to do.
Sure, let's montage. Let's go.
What does the blue bubbly potion do again, Neil?
I wrote all that down. The blue one is a potion of invis.
The bubbly one, because I have two blue and I have a bubbly blue one.
Oh, I didn't write. I told you to write that one down.
There were two healing potions. Which are the blue ones? An invisibility one.
Okay. Yeah. So the bubbly ones are the healing ones.
No, the bubbly one is the invisibility, I think.
Okay, that's
probably
right.
The blue potions are healing, and then I have a purple one, which we know it does, but I don't think we told people, and let's keep it that way, because it's really cool.
Okay.
Will be a big reveal.
Yep. And then I have the green one, as well as that scroll that we might think is cursed.
Well, it's like 1 in 100, but yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's Neil. It's cursed.
Oh, that's true. He's trying to kill us really bad right now. Yeah.
It'll summon the Tarrasque, or the Tarrasque, or however the fuck you say it. I don't know. Anyways, I think we just shirtless montage it, Neil.
Okay. A few days pass. A week passes? However much time passes until Ron arrives.
Pretty sure it was about a week is what you said.
I think it was a rough
week. We did it, guys! We lived through!
Okay, Ron shows up on horseback coming into town. You guys can see him trotting down the road from your position in the tavern. And he seems to just be like walking through town on his horse, trotting through town on his horse, not knowing exactly where to go.
But I run see him to him as if like I go to hug him and really like, I'm pretty happy Ron's there, but like I want to see that armor, right? So I go up and give him a big hug though.
All right. He is seated on a horse, so that's an awkward like torso hug for you.
Mm-hmm.
Torso slash crotch hug. He, you know, pries you off after a moment. Sorry, my speakers are buzzing. And says, well, I got your armor here if you got the other half of my payment.
So the remind me, Neil, how much did I pay him the first time?
It should be noted on your character sheet.
I just subtracted the money. So here, Ron, here is the other 40 gold that I owe you.
I think it was close to 150.
I just like Ryan's face.
Just let me wait for chat to catch up. Chat knows.
Ryan, okay. Just write this shit down, bro. How hard is it?
I subtracted the money from the thing. Like,
just make a note. I owe Ron this much money. How hard is that, bro? Come on.
I wrote down that Ron owed me my armor. I got half of it. Okay.
It's,
all right.
It's been like 18 months of roleplay, bro. Just make a note.
I know. There's so much in there
now,
right?
Just make a note. Just a note.
There's so much in there. Okay. I will give.
Okay, you owe him another 250.
Wait! Whoa!
I'm seeing 250 and 500 mostly.
So you can't trust.
You can pick between 250 and 500.
They're trolling, bro. Look at all this shit. Okay.
Yeah. But Ryan, the thing is, they're trolling, but you didn't fucking write it down. So now you're gonna pay for it.
All right.
So you can roll 250, or I can just roll a number. All right.
So I'll give him 125.
420.
No, you owe him another 250.
No fucking way, because I'm out of money. There's no way I made a deal for more money than I had.
How much money do you have?
I have 150 gold left.
It sounds like you probably didn't have enough money to pay him up front.
No, come on, dude.
Come on, dude. Come on, dude.
Spread the chat. It's 250 total. It's 250 total.
I don't think so. I think it's 500 total.
Oh.
Gosh, if only someone had money for that armor.
Yeah, there's ways to solve this without arguing.
They're just trolling to make me salty. That's it.
Yeah. Yeah. It's so worth it.
So I give him 125 more. I think that's right. I'll tell you what. I'll give him that now.
Isn't it?
Say what?
He looks at it and says, this is a little light.
How about I give him 125 and I'll go back and watch the VOD. And if it's not right, then I will subtract more from my sheet. But I'm literally left with 25 gold left here. All right, fuck
I'll watch the VOD and I'll go back. And if I'm wrong, then I'll owe him like 275
yeah,
gold.
We'll just put that shit in there. Okay.
Next time, all right, Ryan, next time you don't remember, whatever I deem reasonable, whether it's not reasonable or not,
but
goes,
isn't that
right?
what
write your shit down next time,
but
bro.
Ron should also remember that too. All right, whatever.
Write your shit down. I have to remember an entire world. You can remember your interactions with one NPC.
That's the truth.
That sounds like an excuse. All right.
Ryan, Ryan, send me your address, the money that you're hosting my channel for. I'll send you some pins. All right, I'll Amazon them overnight.
Like, but then I can't
some
afford
pins. It's a new age space age device which bleeds ink and you make symbols with it.
Interestingly enough, space age, yes, but not space appropriate. They actually use pencils up there. Did you know that?
Really? I guess that makes sense because the ink wouldn't
go to the,
would it not reach the ballpoint of the pin, like the bottom?
I don't know, but I just know that they use pencils in
Graph.
That
makes
sense.
I didn't know that.
All right. So I exchange.
We learned something today.
I give him 125 gold, right? This is acceptable for this instance.
DM only in a Ryan game.
Only in a Ryan game. Okay. Hashtag Ryan game. And I give him 125 gold. And I now have full plate back.
What? You have full plate, not three quarter back. That was the whole purpose of this, is so that you could get full plate, right?
Right. Yeah, yeah. That's what I'm saying. It's like very well fitted full plate, correct?
So what is your AC then?
It will go to...
It would be 18?
It will be 19.
The armor will provide you with a bonus of AC, with 9 AC.
Right.
You're not using a shield, right?
Well, he has his tower shield that gives 3 AC, but he wears it on his back.
Right, right.
So I can't use it, but I don't use it all the time because it's huge, so I can't really use a weapon with it.
My God. Let's just handle this real quick because the chat won't shut the fuck up until we say it. Okay, NASA spent millions to develop a pen that would work in outer space. It was the Russians that used pencils because they didn't want to spend millions. Thank you, guys. We're past it now.
We figured it out.
Thank you. Jesus. I'm going to have. You know what?
Also
I'm going to
an troll open
the
legend.
Fuck out of you guys. Someday. I'm going to be like, you know what? Did they ever discover Bigfoot? Was that ever just like?
You should go the on the.
The reason the U.S. didn't want to use a pencil in space is because that it would the if you break a pencil, you have little bits of graphite floating around, which can fuck with electronics. There's a reason we developed pens. Pencils are bad. Also, Russia didn't use pencils. They also used pens. That's an urban legend. Check
now you
scope.
Got Neil going off. Can we just check fucking
scopes,
play
guys,
D&D?
I have one of those $1 million pens. It's right here.
Yep.
This is it.
Ryan got it for all the script
writing.
Yeah, but
you got it from Neil for $500,000, didn't you?
Yeah. Well, I thought it was $1 million, and the chat was like, no, it's $5 million. And then Neil was like, that's what I remembered. And then it just like everything went to shit. I don't know.
You know, to be honest, though, you have zero defense about remembering things because I want to see your character. You're going to like upload it someday. It's just a blank piece of paper. Of, like,
I'll upload my character.
I think I have 18 strength. What do you got?
Dude, all right, here's what I did. I subtracted the gold and I thought I would remember, but then we waited like a long ass time to play roleplay again. And
a
then,
week later. Yeah.
No, it was like longer than that. All right. So, anyway. So the armor is 9 AC, Neil, by itself?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so I have 9 armor, 10 base, and 1 cloak. So 20 AC,
mm-hmm.
or 23 with the shield.
And right. 21 versus missile for some reason.
Okay. What?
Why is it 21 versus missile?
Why? I have 21 versus missile on the character sheet. I don't know why it's there.
I think his AC was... At some point, used to be 20 with the shield, but then the shield gets a plus 1 against missile attacks. So if he uses his shield, he has 23 AC or 24 versus missile attacks.
Gotcha. All right, I need to update that on my end. Cool. All right, we'll see you. We're gonna take our break now. We'll see
you. I'm gonna go watch the VOD. BRB.
No, I'm joking. Please continue. Let's actually play.
Okay. So, right, so I'm in the middle of the street, or like he's out on the outskirts of town.
No, you guys are in the near the tavern. You're like in the middle of town.
I take the armor back up to the room and change.
Okay, you have changed into your armor.
Sweet.
By the time you come back downstairs, everyone's chatting with Ron. He looks at Leah. Are you with the party?
She hangs out in the woods.
I was always being invisible and shit.
No, I'm being serious. Like, that's what she did. Yeah.
So I guess I'm not there.
Okay. He looks around and says, "Where's the dwarf?"
About the dwarf. Look, things got rough on the passage. Spades is dead as shit. She's super dead.
Well, she knew the risks, he says, kind of callously.
Indeed. To get you up to speed, though, we are working with a former Verossi, I guess we can call her a double agent. We're not really sure her name. It's Leah or Lazy. I don't know. It's Lay something. She's actually proven her worth, though. We were able to track down two agents that were going to bring an army here due to her help. So we trust her for now, but I want you to keep your eye on her. She's in the forest invisible, by the way. She's an invisible person.
No, I tend to be in the like one of the rooms invisible.
Okay. She's a spellcaster, then?
Yeah.
Kind of. Like a non-combat spellcaster. Wait. She will help protect herself. And
I don't know what she does. We'll see, Ron. But she does have spellcasting abilities, yes.
I kind of say that under my breath.
But now that you're here, Ron, we can continue our journey. We have to go south because I don't know why, and then we head east to get to the Long Kingdom.
Well, just as a reminder, I'm probably going to be taking off pretty soon. Things are getting a little hot, and I like to keep my neck.
Absolutely. You pick your spot, friend, and you've done more than enough to help us.
You say this Leah Lazy person was former Verossi turned something?
Yes.
That's what she says.
She knew of the baby and did not report the child, and she helped us slay two high-ranking spies. So we actually have pretty powerful stuff right now. We have two notes from Lady... something.
You know, I can't remember her name. They're important notes.
Lady Felicity. He glances around the room slowly and says, "You know what? I think I'm taking my leave right now then."
Well, it's been good, Ron.
This smells bad. And I'd like to keep my head. So best of luck to you, Victorian.
Ron,
Mr. Zanzel.
Ron, can I talk to you real quick at the bar? You know, drink for the road?
Why don't you talk to me on my way out? And he dusts himself off and starts walking towards the door.
I stand up and collect my staff, and I walk over to where Ron is standing, and I'm like, "Ron, I want to make you an offer. You've done good by us, but we can't talk about this in public. I don't know who's listening. If you want to dip into an alleyway or something, I'll talk to you there. But I don't want to do it in the bar."
Yeah, he walks out, grabs his horse, and starts walking down the street with you slowly.
Okay. I'm like, "Ron, I don't normally make people this offer, but now don't freak out or anything. We're totally good. I'm just asking if you want this. You've been a great help to us. I don't know how to say this, but do you want to be a dragon?"
Excuse me?
I've come under the knowledge of some cool things, and you know, I could make you a dragon.
Do you turn me into a dragon?
Yep. Or you know, maybe there's something else you want to be. You let me know. I'm just trying to help a friend out.
Zanzel, you batty old man, you. I'm gonna miss you.
Like, really? Yeah. All right. I figured that was the case. You have a good one. You have a good one. I slap his horse.
You too. He smiles pleasantly at you and hops on his horse and starts trotting down the road.
Okay. I walk back to the bar.
Okay, around now, Tariq comes down.
Okay.
Yeah, Tariq, like, you're looking good.
Dusting the dirt off my shoulders, like feeling good.
We should probably get the fuck out of this town.
I'm ready.
Vincent, you good?
Victorian is.
Victorian, sorry, I slipped. I knew a Vincent once upon a time.
Yes. We are, I'm ready to go. We just need to get Carla, the babe, and we should be on our way.
All right, I'll go see to Carla.
And I guess I'll grab Leia. She's up there somewhere. So
okay.
I go upstairs and grab Carla first.
Neil, before we leave, can we say that during this time I acquired a rat that I'm keeping in my bag?
Oh, God.
In the town.
How do you acquire a rat?
The well, only I thing mean, in this
I
town
would look
ferrets.
For one, and then I would just put it in my bag.
I don't understand.
I have, weeks. You, walk around in a town, and then you find a rat, and then you put
have
it
you
in
ever
bag.
Tried to catch a rat? Jen, like you as
okay.
a person.
I hold person on the rat.
Hold
it actually doesn't work. Yeah.
Hold rat.
Yeah, you need a hold animal. It's a different spell. Priest
I thought it was person was like humanoid. Like the
humanoid,
hold.
Yeah, but a rat isn't humanoid. A rat is...
Oh, you're right. Yeah,
yeah,
true.
You can't... Yeah. You
it
can
could
buy
be
a
humanoid
rat,
rat, you know what I mean?
Okay,
from
I buy
a
rat
person.
Then.
Well, no one sells rats. No one sells rats. You could buy some. You could buy a cat. You could buy another small animal. Probably, but maybe buy a ferret. But
they're a delicacy now.
Well,
you guys know that.
Then, yeah. Let's say I went to a shop and I bought a small rodent-like creature.
Okay, let's just roll a die.
Decide which rodent I get.
A 6. You get a weasel.
Deal.
You have bought a weasel.
Okay, I keep it in.
It now lives in your backpack.
Perfect.
What do you name this weasel? Weasley.
Mr. Mogwoggles.
No, I'll find a name. I need I haven't named it yet. I'll figure it out.
Okay. So, where do you guys go, and how do you contact Leia to let her know that you guys are leaving?
Well, I go upstairs. I guess we would know that she's in the rooms, right? Because that's what we were told. So I go out. I go up, collect Carla and the babe. Tell them, hey, we're getting ready to leave. Let's go. Make sure you get ready. I'm gonna go find Leia, and I guess I leave and go into each one of our rooms and say, is anyone there? I look like a crazy old guy, but I do it. Anyways.
Hey.
Until you come into her room.
Yeah.
I take it you don't lock your room, Jen?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, I knock and walk in. I'm like, we're leaving if you're in here.
Yep, ready.
Oh, there you stuff. Are. Okay. Yeah. All right. We'll be done. Oh, by the way, I got this this scroll. Maybe you know what to do with it. I have no idea what it is, and I do not want to mess with it. But here you go. And I put it on the table and walk out. We'll be downstairs.
I take it, but I don't do anything with it yet.
And then we get ready to go, Neil.
Okay. You guys round up Carla and Margaret. And you're all ready to trek off. Ron appeared around noon-ish.
Okay.
Ish. Okay. So, you guys leave, and you are headed towards Lake Tasia along the road. So there's only really one path for you to take. And let's see how that path goes for you.
Yeah, let me open up the maps. Because I have no idea where we're going. We're at Dawra?
Dawra, D-A-W-R-A-H. It is in the center of the map.
Yep, I see it.
Yep.
I'm scrolling up to message you spells real quick.
Cool. Okay, so... you guys get down to Zigston 1, 2, 3, 4 days later. You arrive in Zigston late afternoon. Sun has not set yet, but it is declining. And as you arrive in Zigston, you are stopped by the guards that are standing outside the city near the road. Since there's not a wall around it, there's just 6 guards, arms crossed. 3 of them are guards of Miklagard, this region, and 3 of them are guards of Varassi.
What can I do for you, guardsmen?
We're searching the road for some people coming this way.
Ah. Okay. What are the people you're looking for?
Starts looking you guys up and down. A woman and 2 guys. Well, okay. A woman, two tall men, and a weak man. You guys are 2 women, 2 big guys, and an old man.
Who is stronger than he looks, by the way. But,
right, yeah, there's no weakness in that man.
What?
We've come across many people.
That man is as old as dirt.
He is as old as dirt.
I'm actually older than dirt.
I have an artifact from the Age of Mist that is younger than that man.
I believe it. Listen, I wish we'd have been told earlier. We came across a lot of people, but none are... I mean, maybe some fit the description, but, you know, that's kind of nondescript. A woman and, you know, two guys and a weak guy.
Yeah,
we saw a lot of people.
Will you hold on? They kind of step back a few ways, and they confer for a few moments between each other. You guys have a...
We confer as well.
Yeah. I don't like this. They know. They have your description.
Well, you guys are all on horseback, so it's difficult for you all to be part of a single conversation.
The horses, Neil, if you pack them, like, butt to butt as a flower... No, I'm just kidding. Go ahead.
I give Victorian a look like battle perhaps may ensue soon.
I look at him blankly with my skull mask on. But he knows that look as yes.
I feel the look through the skull mask.
Right.
I move kind of to the... I, like, turn my horse around and start, like, getting to the back ranks. Neil, that makes
Same.
Sense.
Same. I'll follow him.
Okay. They come back a few moments later and say, you mind if we look through your stuff?
No. Just know that we are battle-hardened, not necessarily mercenaries, but we know these roads are dangerous. So you're going to find weapons, and as long as you're okay with that, then that's fine by us.
Yeah, that's fine. They start going through your stuff. They start with your stuff, Victarion. What do you have with you? Just list your gear that you have on your character sheet.
Couple of boule plates still, my weapons, of course, the 3-4 potions. I don't think I have the horn, or maybe I do have the horn.
Don't we have like 2 writs of passage?
Ferret jerky, we have the notes, yes. An absolute ungodly amount of money because I'm the richest man in the entire planet.
You do have the 2 Verossi notes though? The 2
He doesn't have 2, I think you have 1. I have the
one. I have 1.
Okay, one of the guards, as he's like going through your bags of shit, he comes
he can
across
read
that.
It. Yeah.
Reads it, folds a note.
Neil.
Says, okay, guys, you can let them go.
Come on.
Let them go. It's fine. It's fine. They can pass through here. No problem, everyone. Just let them go.
I grin.
I'm a little bit upset that they criticized me. So as I walk by, I'm very pompous and like, I can't believe you just made us do that.
Are there hrumps coming out of you, do you think?
Probably, yeah. I never said, I guess I have a long flowing beard, but like the mustache part is like being kicked up by these prompts or whatever, and then falling back down as I walk by. Very upset.
Okay. As you guys pass them, you hear, the 3 Verossi guards arguing with the guy who had let you pass, and they seem to be kind of pissed off. You can't hear the exact words that are transpiring, but the guy says something, and the guards like completely shut up, and they all look at you. All 6 of them just look at you guys like with awe. Like, oh,
after
shit.
I notice that, I'm going to go try to tell the party to wait a minute. I'm going to go in a corner, and I'm going to cast clairaudience on that area.
So you go into town then? Because they stop you on the road before town.
Yeah, but I thought you said we went away and then they kept looking at us and pointing.
I mean, I'm talking like immediately in the, you know, 15 seconds that pass.
Well,
because you can't hear anything after, you know, once you're like 60 feet away, the sound of your hooves is too much to hear anything.
Well, is there any cover I can go to? Like,
you'd have to go into the town and then hide around a corner or something. It could be done.
Well, that's what I'm going to do as soon as possible. But, like, don't... I won't, like, run there and be super obvious that I'm trying to do something.
Okay. Sure. You go around a corner and eventually cast...
I look around, make sure there's nobody checking, then...
The rest of the party, what do you do when she goes around this corner?
Do you tell us you're doing this?
I'll say, wait a minute, I'm going to check what they're seeing. I'll say that.
I guess we just kind of wait.
Yeah, we just kind of wait. We hold it and pull the horses back.
We do the horse flower. You know what I mean?
Yep,
yeah, you guys
the horse flower
for a moment.
The horse flower is just another reason to get my horse to shit on Jeff's horse more. It's a mini game that we play.
It's the horse centipede.
Yep.
Oh. Yep. It's where you patrol your horses in a very, very tight space.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Jen, you hear. You cast clairaudience.
Yeah.
And you hear the 6 people talking back and forth. They are all talking about Lady Felicity and the fact that they narrowly escaped with their lives. They're all kind of like, holy shit. I can't believe we got to be careful how we approach this shit. You know, there's agents walking around all the time. Like, they could have killed us for no reason and just walked away with it and would have been fine. Like, we got to be more careful when we approach people, guys. This is dangerous. And that's what they're talking about.
All right. So I'll go back to the party and I'll say they definitely, well, of course, it was on the notes. Now they know that they think that we're with Lady Felicity. So if people are smart and talk, they're going to figure out that either you guys got a note or they're going to think that you're with her or they're going to figure out that I'm with you.
Okay.
It was inevitable, but yeah. I didn't plan on the guard reading. Not a lot of people read in this area, so it's kind of... It was quite the strange turn of events that he was able to read that note, but yeah, we'll be okay.
Should we try to get rid of them?
The notes?
No, we keep them.
No, absolutely not. I mean, these guys that read the notes before...
Oh, Leah, you're so Verossi. It's adorable sometimes, but... No, we don't just kill everyone. Killing them will create more questions as well, and eventually people will see us, and it gets bad.
I agree.
We could just take down the whole village, then nobody will tell.
I know, that's the Verossi way, but yeah. We don't do those kind of things anymore. Just need to protect the baby.
We could definitely, throwing it out there, Lady Felicity gave the order that we can burn villages without questioning. So if we did burn it, it could look like it was a Lady Verossi order.
Okay, look, well, that's good to know.
It's strange that you keep our... Let me be very clear, we're not killing the entire town. The mouth. No more, please.
Okay. As you wish.
You're a spy master, you're great, but we don't kill entire cities of people. That's so feng shui, if you will.
I kind of get in the middle of Victarin and Leah's. I sense it's heated somewhat. And I'm like, you know what, Leah, we should... I'm very interested in what you just cast. We should, you know, maybe I'll show you my spell book and you can take a look at mine. We'll see how it goes.
Sure. Yeah, I can show you some. We can share, at least talk about it. How about we sit some night and discuss our spells?
Sounds good. And don't worry about Victarion, but really, we're never going to kill a whole town. We're just don't ever bring that up again. I just keep walking. And we ride into whatever this town is, Neil.
You arrive in Zigston.
Okay.
It's a pretty uneventful stay here. The night passes fairly quickly in town. Nothing else is really remarkable other than that first interaction where you were stopped by the guards. Is there anything in particular you want to do here? If not, we can just keep going.
We're shopping anything. Okay. I don't think so.
Cool.
We didn't take anything from the trolls, right? Because there's not much that we knew that you could salvage from them. We gave a tooth to the lady, I think. Used the leg for identifying of the boy.
I just wanted to get out there. Yeah, I didn't know anything about you.
Yeah.
Okay. While you're hanging... Oh, go ahead.
Can I disguise as a man? Because I have disguise ability.
You have the disguise proficiency?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you just needed an outfit.
Yeah, do you have a disguise? Yeah,
Where is my player's handbook?
Or just as another person, worst case scenario.
I used to do this with Largo. Like, you just had a disguise and put it on, and then you rolled for how well it was disguised.
Yeah. A, B, C, D. Disguise. The character with the skill is training the art of disguise. He can make himself look like any general type of person of the same height, age, weight, and race. A successful proficiency check indicates the disguise is successful, while a failed roll means the attempt was too obvious in some way. A character can also disguise himself as a member of another race or sex. In this case, a -7 is applied to the proficiency check. A character may also attempt to disguise himself as a specific person with a -10 to the proficiency check. These modifiers are cumulative, thus it is extremely difficult for a character to disguise himself as a specific person of another race or sex. So if you want to do just like, I want to just look like someone different, straight proficiency check plus some money spending on equipment, clothes and whatnot. If you want to get like disguise yourself as a different race, -7, as another sex, -7. As a specific person, -10 as a specific race person, -17 as a specific race sex person that isn't your own sex, -24.
Okay. So my check is 12. If I add -7, like what roll do I need in order to
You would need a D20 plus 15, or sorry, D20 plus 5 that would need to be a 21 or higher.
So you'd need a 6.
Okay, I'll just do standard disguise.
Okay.
Important little note here. Did we ever roll for Leia's hotness?
No.
I don't think we did. We talked about it.
Can we get that roll?
Did you guys roll for hotness?
We all have hotness scores.
I am plain Jane, thank you very much.
All right, Leia. Everyone else rolled for it. You got to roll for it.
I'm a 14. Tariq's a 16 or something crazy like that.
17, I'm going to say, or 18.
Yeah.
Victorian, I think you got like an 11.
Yep.
What's the hotness roll?
3d6. No, 4d6.
Oh, my God.
One.
Oh, I'm missing a d6.
Let's take the 14, though.
Okay, yeah,
so
yeah.
15. I'm a 15.
No. It's 4d6 drop the lowest, so 14.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah, 14
is still very beautiful, Jen. Don't you worry about
14's
it.
14's pretty good, right?
14 out of 18, yeah.
The fuck?
What, Zanzel?
I'm a 14.
So you're equal to the old man.
Well, he's like a
except that I'm like 93.
But he's an old version of a 14. I'm a new version of a 14.
Yeah. Exactly. All right.
Tariq is like Ty Gibson, though. He's...
I was thinking him more like a Chris Pine type deal.
Oh, you think he's white? Interesting.
Yeah.
Tariq is super black, by the way.
Is he?
Who's Ty? I just Googled Ty Gibson. I don't know who that is. The first image is some like nerdy ass looking dude in a lawyer suit. Seriously, Google Ty Gibson first image.
I think it's Ty Gibbs, or I can't remember his name, but he's. Or am I thinking Tyrese, maybe?
You gotta Google it now. It's so
far. All right.
It's great.
Ty Gibson.
It's so good.
That's so fucking specific. There is the guy I was thinking of, though, five over to the right, but that's funny. Ty Gibson. That's not even a lawyer. That's like a pastor for a Mormon church or something.
That's not. I think this is.
Yeah, that's him. That's Tyree. That's
me. In a nutshell, that's me.
Oh God. Neil, just continue on because we'll keep laughing at this for a while.
I can't even find what you guys are looking for.
Just Ty Gibson. Ty Gibson.
I did, and I got a basketball player.
Go to images.
E-Y.
First image.
Look at images and look at the first person.
Yeah, I'm not getting anything. I'm disappointed.
Well, how are you doing this wrong?
Yeah. Are you just doing T-Y?
Yes, that's how you spell Ty. No.
Did you do T-I-E?
This is someone that thinks Halibrid is a weapon. All right, Jeff.
That's true.
Whatever. Anyway. Don't even start on the combat shovel. I hate that stuff.
Combat shovel!
No.
All right, I will call my weasel Meepo.
Meepo?
Pretty original.
There's only one of them, though.
I mean, at least she didn't go as stupid as like a Final Fantasy character or something.
Meepo the first.
So while you guys are hanging out in Zigston, as you like settle down into your tavern for the evening, or into your inn for the evening,
sure.
You hear in the common room about how a war has broken out between Aros and between Miklagrad. Aros is the northern half, or the northern fifth
That's
of the kingdom.
That's where we killed the prince, right?
It's the place where you kill the prince. Yeah. Right, it's the area that you just came from. And it seems that war has finally broken out between the upper kingdom and the lower kingdoms.
And what was the other one? Miklagrad?
Miklagrad.
Is that
Miklagard?
They're not towns, right? They're like big
sections. Well, they're regions.
Miklagard is a city. It is also the name of this whole kingdom, which is three sub-kingdoms, what used to be three sub-kingdoms. But it's now one region that's been... basically, everything north of Lake Tasia is Miklagard area.
Gotcha. I'm pretty sure that was our doing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and people seem to be very... concerned about it because it's like a civil war and folks are unhappy, but they seem to be very, you know, very strongly sided one way or the other on
as it. I hear this conversation or one of them, I kind of mosey up to someone and say, well, where does Vrasi fly in themselves in this, because they rule over everyone, so how do two under, you know, dominions go to war? I don't understand that.
Well, it's over Verossi that they're going to war. The Upper Kingdom wants to throw out Verossi and burn them all at the stake. Lower Kingdoms here are siding with Verossi. So I guess you could even look at it as not a civil war, but a rebellion against Verossi's forces as a whole.
And I heard Verossi killed the prince of Alros. Is that correct?
Well, shit. There's been a lot of talk about that. Could have been Verossi people. Might have been the guy's own brother. He'd been causing a lot of problems. No one really knows how he died. But a couple days before he died, they say that Fort Eska burned to the ground. Very few survivors. So something's been going on up there. You get too close to forests, and that's what happens. All manner of beasts come out of the woods at night.
Dangerous place to be, friend. Dangerous place to leave.
Yeah, yeah. You look the warrior type. You gonna join up with the army? I hear them.
You know, I fight for myself typically. So I mean, I guess if the coin's good, yes. But we'll see.
Well, should head over to Haldren. I could use your type there. I think they're putting together some forces to march north.
That's the big city down the way, isn't it not?
Yeah, yeah. A couple days down south.
They're going to march north on Eros?
I don't know the mind of the leaders, but I presume. I mean, hell, that's what happens when you go to war, right?
Oh, yeah, it is. You know what? I'm going to give you 100 silver because I literally have no other use for this, and I want you to have it, so... Drinks on me, okay?
100. His eyes go wide and he goes, yeah, thanks, buddy.
No problem.
Cool. And he just kind of like sweeps it, you know, he puts the bag on the table. It's this big bulging bag of coins and brings his friends over and they all kind of give you a friendly wave and a pat on the back and they order you a drink and they all seem quite friendly and taken with you.
He enjoys the attention, but, you know.
Yeah, a few minutes later, you know, everything else kind of fades away. And we should probably break here.
All right, cool. We're going 3 more hours today, so a lot more roleplay coming up. Can't believe we're going to be roleplaying for 8 hours today, Neil and Ryan.
You guys are crazy.
It's a good day.
We used to do this shit every week. This is our go-to. One campaign, 8 hours straight, no stopping.
We did eight, what? No, we didn't.
No, this is what I used to do in the old days.
Oh, I was like, Neil, did you like continue with little miniatures of us after we quit?
That's how I plan out the next
What are you not telling us, Neil?
Oh, yes, Jen, I will cast that spell. Thank you very much. Your hair smells lovely.
It makes the whole Jeff seducing Carla thing a lot weirder when it's just me and dolls.
Well, you say weirder to act normal to us, but you mean fun, right? Is that what you...
Yeah, I really mean fun. I just didn't want to say it publicly, JP. Thanks.
Okay, gotcha. All right, we'll take our first break, guys. We'll come back here in hour number 2 right after this. We'll see you guys soon.